If you've been following up to now, you should have a Linux Mint DVD or USB ready to use. If you have the DVD, you should be able to put that right in the DVD drive, restart the computer, and it should boot right into Linux Mint 17.1 Live. If you're booting from a flash drive, most likely you'll have to change the boot order. We don't want to change it every boot, only this one time. Doing this can be a little tricky until you get the hang of it. When your computer boots up, you should see a hardware splash screen. That should show you what key you need to press for the boot menu. It goes by pretty fast, so you may have to reboot a few times to see it, and then a few more times to press the correct button at the correct time after you know which button to press. You can also do an internet search to find out what key you need to press to get that one-time boot order screen. For my Dell Optiplex, it's F12. Once you get the boot order screen, it's pretty easy. You can use your arrow keys to move up and down. And when you see the USB drive selected, hit Enter. Or the DVD if you're going that route. We're now running Linux Mint Mate live on our computer. It's not installed on our computer. This is the technique that I used to run the three different versions of Ubuntu in the first video. Let's do the same tests for this version that I did in the first video to see how they compare. The first thing we did was go to the internet. So I'll go down to the menu button in the lower left-hand corner, and we see a window opens up with places and applications. And then in the upper right-hand corner, we see something called favorites. If I click that, it changes to all applications. So this is showing us the favorites. To get back to all applications, I click this again. Do you remember what the Ubuntu Mate screen looked like from the first video? Let me open up a picture so we can compare. Notice the menu button on the Ubuntu Mate desktop is in the upper left corner. In Mint Mate, it's in the lower left corner, as well as the default background is different. What I'm getting at here is that Mate is customized for the different operating systems. The Ubuntu Mate desktop is designed for users who like the Ubuntu desktop before they switch to Unity. The Mint Mate version is a little closer to the Windows XP desktop. The Linux Mint Cinnamon desktop is real similar to the Mate desktop. I picked Mate because I felt it was a little lighter and would work on a greater number of Windows XP computers. Let's go on with our testing. The first thing we did was open up a Firefox browser. And that opens up. I can go to the main Linux Mint page by clicking on that heading. The next thing we did was open up a workspace. I don't see workspace in this lower right-hand corner. What I need to do to turn on the workspaces is right-click while I'm on this taskbar. Then add to panel. There's a lot of things we can add on here. I just want the workspace button. That's here at the bottom, workspace switcher. Clicking on that to select it, then add. Now I'm clicking on the second workspace. Coming back to menu, our second one, we opened up a calculator. The third one, we went and opened up a spreadsheet. So I'm going to all applications, Office, LibreOffice Calc. Then the fourth one, I think we just talked about sound and video options. Here we've got Brazero, Banshee, and videos for our video player. Those are the basic tests we did, and everything seems to be working fine in this version. Let's talk about other things we might use the Linux Live DVD or USB for. Sometimes schools or businesses sell old computers, or maybe you're at a garage sale and you're looking to buy an old Windows XP computer at a discounted price. You may want to know if Linux Mint 17.1 Mate will run on it or not. So you've got your CD or USB, you plug it in and power it up. The first thing you want to know is what kind of hardware is on this computer. I will go into Menu, System Tools, System Monitor. Coming up to this first tab, System, we see at the top here Linux Mint has the release, the kernel, and the desktop. We learned about all of that in video 2. Below that shows us some hardware. We've got how much memory is in here, and then the two processors. And then at the bottom, we've got the system status. We can go into processes, see what is running, resources, how much CPU we're using now. And we're using a bit here because I'm recording this as well. So that's taking up some CPU. Then we've got our memory and network. We've got our receiving and sending. This is when you're going out to the internet. You send a request for a web page, and then receiving is when it downloads that web page. The last thing is the file systems. We've got SDB, SDC. SDB is system device. B is our CD-ROM. C is the flash drive we are running Linux Mint from. There's also another way we have to check what is on the system. And that is if we come down to menu, we've got something here called terminal. Now, I'm not going to use the terminal too much in this tutorial series, but I do want to show you a few commands just so you get an idea of what this is for. When you open the terminal, it gives us a way to talk to the operating system by typing in the commands directly instead of the GUI commands. And the command that I want to show you here is called inxi. That stands for Information, Console, and IRC. When I hit enter, it gives us information about the computer itself. And this command would help you if you're looking at a computer and you're thinking about buying it, but you're not exactly sure what hardware is on there. If you type in INXI-F, it gives us a full or more complete look at what kind of hardware is in there. I'm going to make this a little bigger and scroll up so we can see all that's in there. And there's more that this can do, but those are just two basic things that will help you if you're reviewing a computer with a live version of Linux Mint. I'm going to close these. I mentioned that we could run Linux Live on our computer without changing anything on our computer, and that's true. But it's also true that we can change things on our computer or copy some files off a Windows computer that would not boot, provided that there's no extra security or encryption on that computer. In this example, we're going to see how that works. I'm going to click on the computer to open that up, and down here we see 250 gigabyte volume. That's the hard drive on this computer. I want to go into Documents and Settings. Then I'm going into All Users, Documents, Pictures. And we see I've got some pictures. These are out on this computer on the hard drive. If there's a virus on this computer not allowing me to log into Windows, I can get into it through Linux. I've got my flash drive here that has my Ubuntu-Mate picture on it. And I want to put these photos onto that flash drive. These don't necessarily have to be photos. They could be documents or something on a computer that you can't get to. Go in through your Linux Live and recover them. I'll close this. Since we can get to the files on that computer, we can also run antivirus software like ClamAV from a Linux Live distribution and try and remove a Windows virus, making it possible to log back into that Windows computer. We saw on the Pendrive Linux website a USB called SARDU in the last video. This had some Windows restore tools already on it. It might be something worth looking into if you're in need of a Linux Live USB for Windows recovery. Another Linux Live tool is called System Restore. Either one of these distros can be run from a CD or USB and might be able to help you repair or recover files after a Windows virus, providing there's no extra security on that computer preventing it from running Linux. Now, a word of caution. When you can change files on another computer operating system, you have the possibility of causing great damage to that operating system. So please use extreme caution when accessing an operating system from a Linux Live distribution. Now I'm going to shut this down, and although we booted from a flash drive, it thinks we booted from the DVD, so it's going to ask me to remove the DVD and hit enter before shutting down. In the next video, we're going to dual boot our computer, meaning we're going to leave the Windows system on there, but add in Linux Mint 17.1 and be able to boot into either one of those operating systems.